guys, we're here in my apartment. I just got done making the best breakfast panini I've ever had in my life. It had eggs and cheese and sauteed spinach, mushrooms, onions, garlic, you name it, it was on there. It was phenomenal. Just what I needed for a little catch up between studying and waking up and going to school and work and everything that's been going on, which is why I wanted to follow up with the second podcast on the ProStart Invitationals. This one's more about nationals and how to prepare for it, what judges are looking for, what the teams are expecting out of it, how they're going to prepare for everything. I mean, when I went to nationals, if I had had this, I think, you know, we would have been a little more prepared with what the judges were thinking about and what they wanted to see from us than just going in and having no clue what was going on. So I hope you guys get some really helpful hints from this and, you know, take a quick look.
We're at the Breakfast of Champions this morning, where each team from North Carolina and South Carolina that won the culinary and management are here. As you can tell, they're enjoying some big breakfast, which I might try to get myself a little plate.
How many hours do you think you put in?
For this competition, I know we put in 100, and he was saying 104, that was 104 just starting in December, and we've been practicing since October.
So you guys kind of fed up with management stuff?
Not really.
No, they're not. Not at all.
Culinary.
And this is your first time going?
Second time.
Second time. So yeah. What are you guys going to do differently this time?
Practice, actually. Lots more practice.
This is your first time going to nationals and competing, right?
Yeah.
And did you guys have fun?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Are you guys nervous? What do you expect at nationals?
I was nervous yesterday.
Really?
Like, because I was in management, so I was really nervous.
Nice. What do you guys expect to do in California besides the competition?
Bring your bathing suit.
How are you guys going to prepare for this?
Well, I always say after school, a lot of hours like we do now. And we just work our butts off.
So what are you guys cooking?
Scallops, lamb, and lemon custard.
Do you like any of that?
Mm-hmm.
You do?
I love it.
What's your favorite food ever?
Chicken.
Chicken?
Yeah.
Just cooked or baked or fried?
Fried.
She's from South Carolina, everyone.
Lauren, were you part of the national team that went to San Diego last year?
Yes, I was.
Tell us a little bit about San Diego.
There's a lot of people, a lot of tough competitors.
Any hints out there for someone going to nationals this year?
Be very prepared and
work our butts off.
Bring your bathing suit.
Have your measurements exact.
Right now, we're going to see if we're going to get the texture out of this scallops and the greens right here, and at the same time, the flavor out of the sauce.
The risotto had a good flavor. It wasn't quite as creamy as we had expected or had hoped based on the menu. And the pork chop had a nice look, but the texture was a little dry because it was overdone. And the prosciutto and the cheese and the sage doesn't come through, but it kind of got lost with the seasonings that are on the outside of the pork itself. It's got this flavor that lingers with you, and it overpowers everything else that's going on.
We always look for a nice balance with the vinaigrette. We're looking for the nice, you know, the combination of the oil and the acid. With scallops, we're looking at a nice char mark seared on the outside and tender on the inside.
Presentation is interesting because it can be tough with coffee and crusting because it tends to look burnt instead of like cooked, you know. So the presentation, though, colorful, you know, different. You have shapes and the different levels that you're looking for. So presentation overall is good.
And when we're looking for a stir fry of vegetables, we're looking for a stir fry type flavor rather than a saute flavor. And the chop, I do the same thing. You know, take the spice blend off the outside so you can get the flavor of what they put on the inside. And there's too much flavor there that clash each other.
Our salad here looks a little small. It's on a really small plate. We probably want to make that a little bit bigger. And most importantly, on this dessert, we never really want food on the rim of the plate. This would have been nice if it was perfectly centered and that sauce drizzled around the pyramid there. Overall, though, portion size here looks pretty good. Salad could be a little bigger.
So I hope that was really helpful to you guys. Remember, practice, practice, practice. Have fun. Be safe. Travel well, pack everything, don't forget your bathing suit. I mean, it's gonna be a great time out in California. I also wanna make a quick shout out and a thank you to Johnson & Wales, the Art Institute, for giving you guys over $500,000 worth of scholarships to go to college for culinary arts, management, all of that fun stuff. So go ProStart, have a great time, and I can't wait to see you out in nationals.